Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. Today's video is going to be another disappointing products video. I feel like I just filmed a video like this a month ago, but I've been testing out so many products over the last few months, so I feel like naturally there are a couple more disappointing products than normal. A lot of you guys said these videos are helpful, which makes me really happy. I just want to film helpful videos for you guys, so if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up or let me know in the comments below, and I can continue filming them on my channel. But if you guys have tried any disappointing products lately, let me know in the comments below so I can either avoid them or just kind of hear your thoughts and your insights into those products. And let's jump into it. So I've been testing out a lot of sunscreens in 2018 just because I made the commitment to wear it every single day, especially on my face, my neck, the back of my hands. I think I've just kind of realized that it is a very important step in my skincare routine. So I'm always looking for the perfect one. Unfortunately, I have not found one that kind of checks off everything on my list to be like my perfect daily sunscreen, and unfortunately the Tarte ChartGuard 30 did not work for me. First of all, this product is very thick, so it takes a lot of effort to blend it into the skin, and then on top of that, it leaves a very intense white cast on the skin. So if you have a darker skin tone than me, it's going to be extremely obvious on you. My skin is pretty fair, and even on me, it was extremely noticeable. So a lot of times I go over it with makeup. If you do, that might not bother you, but honestly, I think it's going to be way too intense for the majority of skin tones out there. On top of that, it just kind of irritated my skin. My skin is very sensitive when it comes to using products with SPF in them. So, you know, a lot of times I'm kind of expecting them to irritate my skin, but it just felt really itchy and uncomfortable when I wore this product on my skin, either alone or under makeup. So for me personally, this one is a pass. I feel like there are other products out there that I enjoy more than this one. So I don't know, if you guys have tried this, let me know in the comments below if it worked for you or if it didn't work for you. So I did just film part two of my Drunk Elephant review. If you guys want to check it out, I will link it in the description box below. But in case you missed that video, I have a little spoiler alert for you guys. The TLC Framboos Glycolic Night Serum, unfortunately, did not work for me. It was just that the more that I used this product, the more that I noticed my skin had additional texture that I didn't really see when I wasn't using this product. In a couple of my videos that I recently uploaded, my skin just looked so, so bad. And it's because I had reintroduced this product into my skincare routine to try it out again to see if it was going to work for me. And every single time I do that, my skin just either breaks out, it looks irritated, it looks just a little bit more texturized than it does when I don't use this product. So unfortunately, there's some ingredients in this product that just don't react well, or that my skin does not react well to. But the frustrating part is that I know a lot of people love this product. Like, so many of you guys told me to try this product, and it's not that I blame you or I think you gave me a bad recommendation. I think it works for a lot of people, and I'm just disappointed that it didn't work for me because I had really high hopes for it. So I placed an elf order a few weeks ago. I grabbed some new products, I grabbed a couple of essentials, and then some older products that I've just been curious to try. I did get their brush shampoo because I wanted to try it out. I've been looking for a good cruelty-free brush cleanser. Honestly, I haven't done a lot of research yet. It's like one of those products that I don't think about until I go to wash my makeup brushes. But like I said, I wanted to try out their brush shampoo, and I felt like this did not clean my brushes at all. It did not remove the makeup, whether it was foundation or eyeshadow or eyeliner. I felt like I had to go through and wash my brushes like three different times with this product. This product might be more gentle. It might condition my brushes better, but if it doesn't actually remove the product from the brushes, then it's not really cleaning them in the first place. So for me, I will not be trying this product again. I just felt like it was such a fail for me. Have you guys tried this out? Did it work for you? I did grab like their daily brush cleanser as well, which I have not tried yet, but the brush shampoo was just like a complete fail for me. So I think I told you guys a few months ago, I stopped getting gel polish on my nails just because I felt like it was damaging my nails. But I have been testing a lot of my regular nail polish because I have a pretty large nail polish collection. It's like over there on my wall. So I've been slowly going through it. It's been so long since I've really worn a lot of it. So I've just been testing out brands and colors, trying to decide which ones are my favorite. Well, I recently tested out the Debra Lipman polishes, and Debra Lipman is cruelty-free, which is awesome because a lot of the nail polishes in my collection are not. But unfortunately, these chipped on me so quickly. Unfortunately, the formula just didn't work for me. My nails do chip so quickly, really no matter what polish I'm wearing, but I do have some that last at least a week, and these ones barely lasted like 24 hours. So for me personally, I will not be buying any more nail polish from this brand. And again, it's an expensive brand, so I just feel like for that price, they better last a little bit longer than 24 hours. So I did just film a review on the Smashbox Vlada collection, which I'll link in the description box below. But again, if you haven't seen that video, I'm going to kind of spoil it for you and share the products that I was disappointed in, just because I know not everybody watches every video, so I kind of like to do a full roundup when I film these videos. So the Petal Metal Shimmer Spray is a product that I just would not recommend. I think $39 is honestly way too expensive for this product. It just did not really do anything special in my opinion. If you guys have tried the Smashbox Primer Water, it's kind of like that with a little bit of shimmer and like a hint of rose gold thrown in. But honestly, once you apply it to the skin, I guess it could depend on your skin tone, but on me personally, you don't even see the shimmer. It kind of blends in with my freckles, and the hint of rose gold just kind of enhances any redness on my skin. I will say that my foundation actually goes on top of this product really nicely, but I think it's because it's pretty much the Smashbox Primer Water with those two extra ingredients thrown in, and my foundation goes on top of the Smashbox Primer Water perfectly. And on top of that, the Smashbox Primer Water nozzle sprays on so beautifully and so evenly, but this product does not apply evenly when you spray it directly onto your skin, so you actually have to spray it into your hand, onto a brush, or onto a sponge. I feel like this could have been a good product in theory, but honestly, I feel like their primer water is such a good product that they shouldn't try to switch it up too much, and I know that they're marketing this as a completely different product, but I really feel like it's the Smashbox Primer Water with shimmer and like a rose gold hint. A product that I felt like at first was like, okay, and then the more I thought about it, I just decided $32 for this product is just not a great option in my opinion, is their Petal Metal Shimmer Drops. These look incredibly beautiful in the bottle. You shake them up because they do separate and they look so gorgeous and they sound really interesting and really cool in theory. If you like to wear glitter, you can actually apply these on the cheeks as highlights or maybe mix them in with your foundation or apply them on the lips to transform your lip color. But once you apply them on top of another product, they don't look like this. They just look like glitter suspended in a clear liquid. And then on top of that, the product itself is a little bit drying. So if you apply it to your lips feel pretty dried out by the end of the day. And if you apply it to your cheeks, I think it might possibly irritate your skin depending on how sensitive your skin actually is. I have very sensitive skin and I felt like it kind of left a little bit of like irritation on my cheeks a few times when I used it, but I would just be very careful if you have sensitive skin. I just feel like $32 is kind of expensive for this product. It sounds cool, the packaging is interesting, the product itself looks beautiful, but it's just not as impressive when you apply it. I feel like you could get a similar look using a glittery lip gloss or a sheer lip gloss or a lip topper. So I don't know, $32 for like this product, I just feel like it's really a ripoff in my opinion. Another product that has the potential to irritate your skin is definitely the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Primer Water Spray. I did review this on my channel in my Wet n Wild review, and I've had the chance to try it out a few more times since then. This product does sting my skin when I apply it because it does have a lot of alcohol in it. So if you specifically try to avoid face products with alcohol in them, you're definitely going to want to skip over this product. I was kind of hoping that it would be a good alternative to the Smashbox Primer Water, but I don't know. I feel like I like how my foundation goes on better when I use the Smashbox Primer Water. There's something about that product that is amazing. That product is actually alcohol-free, whereas one of the main ingredients in this product is alcohol. So I felt like when I applied this product, it irritated my skin. It stung a little bit. It's obviously not an ideal product to put in a priming spray. It's not the end of the world because it was only a few dollars, but if you guys were looking for a dupe to the Smashbox Primer Water, this is not the one. I tried out the Direct Flight Multitasking Dry Shampoo from IGK. This one is the medium cleanse level, and I just felt like it did not do anything for my hair. My hair gets pretty oily, to be completely honest with you guys. I never used to do second day hair until fairly recently. I just don't want to wash it every single day. My hair gets dried out, I struggle with breakage, and I feel like if I can kind of extend the time between washes, my hair is just in better shape. So I'm always looking to try good dry shampoos. I just felt like this one didn't do anything for me, and I was super disappointed because I really enjoy the brand. That being said, they do have three different cleansing levels. This one is the medium cleansing level. They even have one that's lighter than this, but they actually have one that's heavier. So I do prefer the first class charcoal detox dry shampoo. This one is the deep cleanse level. I felt like it just made my hair look clean and refreshed, and neither one of them irritated my scalp at all, which was a big plus because a lot of dry shampoos can irritate my scalp. I didn't think I needed, you know, a super intense cleansing level, but if you have an oily scalp, I would recommend trying out First Class over Direct Flight. I feel like Direct Flight just did not work well for me at all. Okay, guys, that is the end of my video. Thank you so much for watching. I would love to hear from you, so let me know in the comments below if you guys have tried out any of these products and if they worked for you or if they didn't work for you, because I know that everybody has different experiences. But I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.